Hello everyone, welcome to today's do-it-yourself video. I have shown you last time these flower crowns, how to make them, which is absolutely easy. And I just thought we are going to use up the rest of the flowers, which is the leaves and the rosebuds and everything that was left, because it would be a shame to just throw it in the garbage. And you have probably seen already from the name of the video and from the title, from the thumbnail, that we are going to make such cute present boxes, or you know, decorative boxes. So let's start. Here we go. These are the rosebuds that are left from last week. I have also several twigs with leaves, and I have a few boxes from the brand Lush that are already empty since I used up the products, and two of them we are going to change into a present box. So first I cut few of the leaves from one of the twigs, and I'm going to glue them with the hot glue gun on the top of the lid. It's gonna be formed like kind of a star, and I'm going to put in the middle of the lid one of the rosebuds. So you'll see in a few seconds. You have to be very careful since the hot glue is extremely hot, so make sure you do not touch it with your fingers. So if you order the leaves on the top, maybe it's better to push it down with some kind of a tool so that you don't have to touch it. I have the same box here again, but there were some rests of a glue from the sticker that was on it, and I kind of couldn't make it go away. So I've decided I'm going to glue several several rose leaves also on the sides of the box, and we'll see how it's gonna turn out. Okay, this is a lot of green, but we're gonna continue with the green, and we are going to cover the lid the same way we did with the first box. So now I put, as you could have seen, the rosebud again in the middle. And the next step is going to be to take scissors and cut the leaves a little bit back on the sides so that they do not stand in the way when you put the box down. So as you can see, they were a little bit further over the bottom, and it's necessary to cut them a little bit back. So I'm gonna show you both of the boxes next to each other so you can see it changes a little bit, of course, the look. I mean, everyone has another taste. So what I thought I'm gonna show you also on this box, to put a ribbon, you can glue it on and tie it into a bow. And I had another idea which actually didn't turn out to be so great. I tried to glue on some pearls, which actually looked cute. But the problem was, you need to leave space between the pearls so that you would be still able to grab the lid and unscrew it. Plus, anytime I came on one of the pearls, they just broke up and they just fell down. So I have decided to take them down. But here in the video, I left it because I had another idea, or actually my mom had another idea. She said if you would saw the pearls first on the ribbon and then glue the ribbon on, they wouldn't be able to fall down. So I just wanted you to see it when it's finished, so you can imagine how the box would look. And what I've done then at the end, since I've seen that the pearls were falling down, I just broke them down and put just a stripe of lace around the box, and this is how it looked like. And I put one little shiny star in the middle of the bow too. We have still one more box that has been a box of chocolates by the brand Lindt. It's a really delicious chocolate, by the way. And I'm going to put on leaves on the top again. And this time I'm going to put on also rosebuds, but this time two. and I'm gonna put them on in kind of a V form, and in a few seconds I'm gonna turn it around so you can see how the end result looks like. Again, if you're working with the hot glue, make sure that you do not touch it with your fingers because you could burn yourself. It's really not pleasant. So there you go. I'm gonna turn the box around so you can see it. On the bottom of the box, the other way, you can still see that it's from chocolate. So if you want to hide it, you can put on some polish or even glue on more leaves, but I thought it was fine, so I left it that way. And here you can see all three boxes again. Those cute boxes are really super easy to make, and I think they are different. If you have a little present for someone, it is definitely different than the stuff that you buy in shop, because one can tell you made it, and there's the thought that counts to you. So yeah, I mean, I hope you like it. Let me know. I mean, of course, this is again a style that not everyone likes, so I would be interested, is there any of those three boxes that you would like to receive as a gift or even make yourself? My personal favorite, I would say, is this one, because it kind of still looks like a heart, and yeah, I just like the shape. What I thought would be also possible, if you want to, you can cover the writing on the bottom with any polish that sticks to metal, or you could also glue on a bit few of those rose leaves. That depends on you, what you rather like. And with this one, it didn't work with the pearls as I imagined, so that's why I changed it to the lace. But what you could do instead of gluing the pearls on is that you would sew them on the ribbon, and then when they sewed on, I hope I say this word right, that you then you would after that glue the ribbon on and tie it. And that might help it to last longer, but you would still have to keep distance between the pearls so that you can kind of grab the lid with the fingers and unscrew it. So I think this is the easier variation, but it depends on you what you better like. And this one kind of reminds me on a small flower pot, so I think I'm gonna put it on my working table. I think I'm gonna put some stuff in, like small buttons or I don't know how you call those things that you put on your documents. I'm gonna look for one. How do you call those? I have no idea. So let me know maybe in the comments, what is this in English? I can't remember that word, but I know I knew that word, but I kind of forgot it. Now, and anyway, this is just another subject. I'm blabbing again. Sorry, guys. Anyway, if you like this video, let me know. Write me a comment or give the video a thumb up if you liked it. And don't forget to check out my Facebook page and my Instagram. And there's also a webpage with webshop if you're interested in my fashion collection. Links are below. If you're not a subscriber here yet, you are of course very welcome to stay here. Welcome here. And if you want to know what's happening here, just maybe if you want to visit the start page of my channel, because all my videos are ordered by several themes in playlists, and that might help you to find something that's interesting for you. And thank you everyone for watching. It's always good to see you, and see you next time. Bye.